providing an opportunity to work as part of a team, to lead and to perform with grace, dignity and pride in both victory and defeat. In terms of what this event specifically is, the World Schools Netball Cup is an international netball event designed to showcase the talent diversity and sportsmanship of school students worldwide. Over the course of the next 3 days, some of the most talented and determined students in the world will compete at the Loughborough University in a bid to accumulate the most points for their school and be crowned world champions. This year is the third edition of the World Schools Netball Cup after two successful years in 2019 and 2022.
looking at all the pieces of the company for the quite a rest of the world. Yeah.
Thank you. We'll be right back. Hello everybody, and a huge welcome from the Sir David Wallace Arena at Loughborough University for the third World Schools Netball Cup. We are Lucy G and Lucy P from Quarter Time Podcast, and we are thrilled to be leading the commentary team for this super special event.
Yeah, it's going to be a good one, isn't it, Luce? The opening ceremony has now finished, and we have four curtain raiser games tonight before two full days of matches kick off tomorrow and Saturday. And we are delighted to be welcoming 32 teams from across the globe in the under 13, under 15, under 17 age groups, as well as welcoming the under 19 age group to the competition for the very first time.
32 teams, wowza, we have got so much netball coming your way. So the best place to stay up to date with fixtures and the results as they come in throughout the event is on the official tournament app. Just search WSG Netball in your app store to keep up to date with all the action.
And selected matches throughout the event will be live streamed on the World School Games YouTube channel, so stay tuned to the Media Hub on the app for full details.
So first game coming your way then, we have the under-13s from Tonyrefail Community School versus Dubai English Speaking College. We are really excited for this first game to get us underway. What is going to be a truly netball filled weekend.
Yeah, absolutely, Luce. We have got 2x12-minute halves for these matches with a 3-minute break for half time. And the format of the competition, the under 13s, 15s, and 17s will all take part in a group stage and knockout matches across the weekend. And the under 19s are playing a round robin with knockout matches determined by the group standings.
So our point system for the competition, you get 3 points for a win, 1 point for a draw, and nothing, unfortunately, if you lose. But it's not long now until the first game is underway. So we're going to run you through the starting sevens for each team. Luce, take it away.
Yeah, so from the Tonyrefail Community School, our goal shooter, Scarlett Sherlock, that's hard to say. In goal attack, Miley Jo Perry. In wing attack, Hallie Ruck. In centre, Millie Tranter. Wing defence, Amelia McGowan. Goal defence, Kate Shepherd. And goalkeeper, Lily Martenko.
And for Dubai English Speaking College, in goal shooter, we've got Frankie Mann. In goal attack is Danae Hendricks. Wing attack is Layla Lenstra. Centre is Heidi Edgar. Wing defence, we've got Marissa Barnard. In goal defence, we've got Agathe Pinnell. And in goalkeeper, we've got India Clifton.
I'm really looking forward to this matchup. We were also at the World School Games last year for the netball. It was absolutely fantastic. Some really closely contested matches, and of course with Dubai College taking the triple crown, winning the under 13, under 15 and under 17 competitions last year. So yeah, they'll be looking to do the same again this year, I would imagine.
Yeah, but they're going to have some fierce competition on their hands. I would be absolutely gobsmacked if they're able to get the treble again this year. Well, it'd have to be the quadruple, because we've now got the under 19s as well.
Yeah, that's true.
So we'll have to see what they can do as both teams are starting to make their way onto court. I imagine the nerves are high, the anticipation's high. How nervous do you reckon they'll be feeling?
I'm sure they will be, but also, you know, these athletes, they are young professionals. They're used to standing up and performing for their schools on the regular, so I think it's just that extra added atmosphere, you know, here in the Sir David Wallace Arena with the cameras and the lights and everything. It just really brings an extra level to the game. Okay, and we're just getting ready for the first centre pass here. Looking for a ball, I think. Might need one of those.
Maybe. Might help.
But no, this is so exciting, especially, I mean, under 13, just what an incredible experience for these young players to have so early on in their netball careers.
Absolutely, and I think, you know, thinking back to the 2022 competition, the one takeaway, or the main takeaway I had from it, was just how high the standard was across all age groups. And you actually forget just how young they are. Yeah. The talent is extraordinary.
No, absolutely, and they're just fearless. They play so confidently as well, and it's really inspiring to watch.
100%. I mean, I think when I was 13 years old or under 30s, I was not playing netball to this standard, I can tell you that right now.
So here we are, about to get underway. A big shout out to all the umpires and the officials who are helping this tournament to go ahead. We could not do it without them. Really, really useful to have that skill and just that support for the players as well. And a big shout out to all the coaches. I know it can't be easy to take a group of what, 15 or 20 girls could be if you've got a couple of teams for the weekend off to Loughborough. Bless them.
Yeah, I imagine there'll be a couple of extra grey hairs when they get back from the tournament.
I was thinking a glass of wine on Saturday night. Here we are, the match ball now being delivered by the umpire. And we're about to get underway for the World School Netball Cup 2023. Lots of anticipation in the air at the moment. Here we go, first centre pass. Oh, wing attack there, looking for options.
Oh, look at that 3 feet mark by Tonyrefail. Unlucky though not to come away with it.
Beautiful baseline drive there, Danae Hendricks. Good, we've got some nice height in this circle, I have to say. And the first goal of 2023 has been scored, and it goes to the Dubai English Speaking College.
Much to the delight of their teammates who have their lovely red shiny pom-poms to cheer them on their way.
And what a turnover there as well. Oh, just missed that first option there, but really nice movement there from Frankie Mann in goal shooter. Ah, but good to follow her shot and get the rebound, and she doesn't miss on the second attempt.
Yeah, under all sorts of pressure from Lily Martenko there, but still managed to net it away.
Little bit of whistle early on here. They'll be looking to tidy that up. Just gives your opposition a bit of a free shot. Lovely, beautiful high arc on the shot there from Danae Hendricks. 3-0 early doors for the Dubai English Speaking College. Oh, that's a shame. Footwork in the centre circle there, unfortunately. And the ball will be reset here. Remember, just two halves of 12 minutes, so you really have to make an impact early doors. And the Dubai English Speaking College are doing that so far.
Oh, beautiful. Lovely baseline drive there, Danae Hendricks again. We've already said her name a couple of times.
Even had time to adjust her ponytail before she took the shot.
So smooth, man. Yeah. I wish I was that cool.
Lovely depth on second phase there. Oh, that was a beautiful passage of play.
Yeah, absolutely textbook there from the Dubai English Speaking College. What a start to this game for them, Luce.
Oh, stolen. What a move there from Hendricks. Ah, but just a loose ball there. I'm really loving the arms over pressure from Dubai. They are just pressuring every single ball. Look, there they go again. Oh, nearly 3 seconds.
Yeah, I just think some of the timing is ever so slightly out for Tonyrefail. Just need to take a look at that. Make sure they're driving onto the ball as well.
Just getting a little bit stuck in this centre third here, unfortunately. Oh. Obstruction there against Dubai. Oh, second move there from the goal attack, Miley Jo Perry, but it was missed. And unfortunately, it will be another turnover for Dubai.
Yeah, I just think the movement from Tonyrefail is just a little bit too lateral at the moment. We need to get some 45 degree angles going on. This is really great defensive work and attacking work from Dubai, to be fair.
Beautiful feed over there. Danae Hendricks feeding and shooting well early doors. And Frankie Mann pops another one in. Penalty being called there at the top of the D. Oh, that was sensational. Silky smooth there from Dubai.
Yeah, I mean, if they've got any nerves, they're certainly not showing it. Absolutely blistering start to the game. 7-0 so far.
Oh, and they're going to get the throw in as well. Ooh. using the whip nicely there. Oh yeah, that's unlucky, that replayed ball. Deemed by the umpire to have had control.
Oh, but look at that, straight on defence, and she almost comes away with the turnover. That was cracking work from Danae Hendricks.
Oh, really stuck for options there. I think that obstruction was a bit of a get out of jail free card. Lovely pop forward from Mann.
Manages to collect her own rebound, doesn't make the same mistake twice. I'm really liking the timing of the pops on the baseline from Dubai English Speaking College.
Good ball over the top there. Just really accurate on that feed and with the finish as well.
Yeah, utilising the height they've got in that shooting circle.
Yeah, there is a little mismatch, although Lily Martenko is not too much shorter. Frankie Mann seems to be, oh, unlucky there. Frankie Mann has the advantage at the moment. Lovely work there to hit circle edge from Heidi Edgar in the center position for Dubai College. Tournaments are a tough gig for centers, I have to say. As a centre myself.
This is why I'm a goal shooter, Lou, so it is not for me.
Beautiful second move on the baseline there from Mann. And we'll have a Tonyrefail centre pass. Oh, a couple of times there that's happened. They've just gone back on that centre pass. Whoa, just a little bit too quick there, but she manages to hold on to it.
Yeah, lucky not to get the replayed ball call there. Risky ball over the arms of Kate Shepherd.
Lovely rebound from Mann. They're really finding good shooting position, both of these Dubai College shooters. Really accurate as well. I think Leila Lenstra took every other ball in that passage of play there, the wing attack for Dubai.
Yeah, I just love how many options to the ball Dubai currently have. They've got at least two at every phase through court.
And Tonyrefail now, the school, they are from Wales, of course. The first time I think that Wales have been represented at the World School Games. Sure, they had a lot of sweets on the bus journey. Okay, here they are lining up for their first one, but deflected. Ah, but I think it'll be a contact penalty. So yeah. Here's an opportunity here. Oh, I just want to see them go up two hands strong for that rebound. Oh, I think the umpire has blown.
A little bit of confusion as to where the penalty is set. But Scarlett Sherlock, nope, decided she doesn't want to take it. She's going to hand it over to Millie Jo Perry.
I think it was an offside call, so it's in, oh no, contact call. Unfortunate there. Scarlett Sherlock wasn't able to hold on to that one, but back in defence straight away, Tonyrefail.
Beautiful swing to open up the circle, and out pops Frankie Mann.
Well fought there, Lily Martenko. She'll gain a lot of confidence from that turnover. And you just want Tonyrefail to settle a little bit here. Lots of people moving at the same time.
Yeah, just need to utilise a bit of their change of direction if their first lead's being covered and right on cue. Oh, unlucky, there's a turnover to Dubai, but it is a footwork call. What can Tonyrefail do with this?
Oh, the pressure from Dubai. There were no options, unfortunately, coming forward for that ball. And the girls in red have the ball again. Oh, beautiful passing into space there. Hendricks again with the finish.
Yeah, some fabulous speed through court there as well.
Good depth on second phase again there from Dubai. And I really like how Frankie Mann's mixing it up. She can go for the front pop, she can ask for the overhead ball, the baseline drive as well. Really offering a lot of options. Very Kara Konen-esque, I would say.
Yeah, I'd agree with you there.
Contact call then. Now, this is an opportunity here for Tonyrefail. Looking to get their first goal on the board in this first half.
Just need someone to drive towards the ball.
Oh, fantastic defensive work there. India Clifton all over that one.
And look at that placement right under the post for Danae Hendricks, who puts it away no problem.
Dubai again with a lovely centre pass set up. And a nice confident finish.
Yeah, I mean, I know we're only in the first half, but this will no doubt be filling them full of confidence for the rest of the competition as well.
Yeah, unfortunately, Tonyrefail just struggling on that centre pass at the moment.
Yeah, I'd like to see a little bit more work done from their goal attack and wing attack on that first phase.
Yeah, that's the thing about netball, isn't it? You get 50% of the possession. It's all about how you can capitalise. Whoa, what a screamer there. Kate Shepherd. Oh, but unfortunately they couldn't hold on to it. I mean, Dubai just so quick on the defence.
It's a bit like me when I play. Whenever I get a turnover, I get so excited. First thing I do is throw it away.
It's the most. It's the time when you're most vulnerable to lose the ball is actually when you've just won possession.
It is.
That was good. Nice drive there from Miley Jo Perry. Well picked up there again from Miley. And this could be the first goal on the board. And they've done it. Oh. Right at the halftime whistle. My goodness me, the score is 19-1 to Dubai English Speaking College. What a first half, Luce, of our first game of the 2023 World Schools Netball Cup.
Yeah, what a first half indeed. Probably not the half that Tonyrefail were hoping for with the scoreline, but still lots of positives to take away from it. They've managed to score the one time they did have a shot at goal, so 100% shooting record so far. Dubai English Speaking College, I mean, what can you say about them? The defensive pressure through court is absolutely exceptional.
Yeah, absolutely. They're looking very strong. They're looking very structured, particularly that centre pass to goal. Really impressive stuff early doors. We're going to take a short break while the teams have a little rest at halftime, and we'll be back with you very shortly. 30 seconds to go until we get underway for the second half of this game. Just a reminder that we will be bringing you all the action today, tomorrow and Saturday as well. So many matches coming your way. Make sure to get in touch using the hashtag WSGNetball. A bit of confusion about the centre pass. It is a Dubai centre pass because it ended on a goal, of course, at the end of the last half. Here we go, and Dubai have made a few substitutions here, taking the opportunity to give everyone a run out. Obviously, this is the first day of the competition, want to rest some legs. A nice partnership between Mann and Hendricks that we saw in the first half continuing. Strong rebound there. And another finish there from Dubai.
Oh, much better on the first phase there from Tonyrefail.
Oh, few scraps there, but Tonyrefail on the other end of it. Just a little sneaking offside there from the wing defence. Fail. Lovely high ball over.
Yeah, fabulous placement there.
And that's a fantastic start to this half for Tonyrefail, already equaling their score from the first half, and we're only a couple of minutes in. And a good pickup there, really nice work. Lovely drive there from the goalkeeper as well. I love seeing that, don't you, Luce? A goalkeeper really driving hard for the transverse line to bring the ball through.
Absolutely. Seven in attack, seven on defence.
Oh, that is a pity there. Tonyrefail just losing that in the midcourt, and it will be a Dubai sideline. Ah, but a foul throw, I think. Foot on the line. That's one of those pesky rules in netball, isn't it, Luce? Should
yeah.
we get rid of it?
I mean, there's a couple that I'd get real. See, that was a foot on the line there. I think the one before that was actually a footwork call.
Oh, dear.
Might have been a bit of a dragging, but...
Oh, I see.
Just, you know, discipline really needed in netball. It's so hard, though, isn't it? You get so excited.
I think the confusion is that there's two lines. There's a black line and a red line, and we are, of course, playing to the red lines.
Ah.
I think that may have been what was going on there, but it is a little bit far away, so we can't quite see. Lovely pickup there from Hendricks. And a good drive to the goal line, but just a little scrappy there on the finish. And Tonyrefail have the ball again.
Yeah, a little bit of whistle coming Dubai's way now. A couple of cheeky elbows coming out when defending.
What I really like is how Dubai are really hot on the loose balls. Any scraps that are going, they're all over them.
Oh, the bin chickens, as Sue Gordian would say.
Bin chickens. Okay, Tonyrefail with the centre pass again. That's another one of those going backwards. Just lost another one, but there she is back in defence again. Really admire Heidi Edgar, Millie Tranter for the effort that she's putting into getting back on defence. Strong rebound in the air. Frankie Mann. Score now 22-2 to Dubai. Remember, goal difference could be important at the end of the competition, especially if teams are level on points. So every goal matters.
Yeah, I suppose it's a little bit of a balancing act between wanting to get as many goals as you can, but also not wanting to run everyone out and run them tired too early
Very
in the competition.
Very true. You have to conserve energy. It is a marathon and not a sprint, this kind of tournament format. We'd love to know where in the world you're watching from. We know we have a lot of global viewers on the stream today, so do tweet us, use the hashtag WSGNetball on Twitter. We'd love to know where you're from, which team you're supporting, if there's anyone in particular you're excited to see in the competition. Just out of court there. It just felt a little bit frantic in that end. And Dubai College making no mistakes, streaming down court. Ooh, little scrappy there.
I do feel the defensive pressure from Tonyrefail really has picked up though in this half.
Definitely, I couldn't agree more. They've had several turnovers already. Oh, but a beautiful long shot in the finish from Frankie Mann.
Oh, look at that change of direction there from Heidi Edgar in centre. Absolutely beautiful.
And that is number 25 on the board. Oh, good contest there. Unfortunately, called for the contact.
Yeah, it's a strong take though from Tonyrefail under all sorts of pressure. Showing really good hustle.
Well picked up there. Millie Tranter with it. Great hustle there, Dubai. Using one side of the court at the moment. And there they look to centralise. Whoa, lovely ball in, right on the goal line. And just so settled on the shot, isn't she, Frankie Mann? She doesn't look fazed at all. She looks cool, calm and collected.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. In fact, I think the whole team look pretty cool, calm and collected. They each know what their job is, what their responsibilities are. A little bit wayward on that second phase, but Frankie Mann picks it up and puts it away.
Another penalty there against Dubai. Another one there as well. It's really difficult, isn't it, when you've got a player out of play. You have to really capitalise on that opportunity, don't you?
Yeah, and I think sometimes that's where some teams can fall down, because if you telegraph where that's going to go, even though you are a player up technically, it is actually quite easy to get
exactly.
A turnover then.
Oh, beautiful ball there, but unfortunately couldn't be pulled in. And it's going to be a Dubai goal line. Lovely confident play coming down court. Really nice timing as well on that passage of play. Just everyone move into the right space. Bit of a mid-ranger here. Oh, no problem for Frankie Mann. That was sensational.
Yeah, absolutely stunning work from Dubai English Speaking College. Really can't speak highly of them enough. Look at that depth right into the pocket. Big swing to open up Frankie Mann. She's going to go for it.
It's the anticipation, I think, as well, to know that, yes, they're going to get that ball, so I need to get this ball and be able to. It's like chess, isn't it, really? You want to be like a few steps ahead.
It is a game of chess. Netball is a game of chess, absolutely.
Here come Tonyrefail now. Unlucky there. It's going to be a Dubai sideline.
I have to say that the defensive pressure from the wing defence for Dubai is absolutely exceptional. She managed to get about 4 or 5 turnovers in this half alone just by challenging the receipt of the ball on the first phase of the centre pass.
And that was really impressive from Millie Tranter in the centre position. Just hustled onto that ball. Then just that ball needed to be a little bit further ahead, but they've collected it. And they score again, accurate from that range as well, aren't they?
Yeah, and the beautifully quick shot as well.
A few substitutions happening now. Tonyrefail giving the opportunity for a few fresh legs to come out onto court. Just a little bit too quick on that occasion from Dubai. Oh, what a steal, Danae Hendricks. My goodness me. And she'll get it again.
Yeah, I love it when attackers get themselves on the stat sheet for defensive pickups. Absolutely stunning work.
Yeah, she can do no wrong today, the goal attack for Dubai. Again, just no forward option there, unfortunately, on that centre pass. Just makes life a little bit more difficult for your attacking players when you haven't got that easy option. As the centre, you know, with that ball, it's a big responsibility to take the centre pass, and you want to be able to give it away easily in the first couple of seconds.
Yeah, absolutely. I just think the attackers for Tonyrefail just need to step it up a little bit because they are under some fierce defensive pressure. Just a couple of miscommunications now in attack for Dubai. Just want to have a little look at that.
May just be adjusting to the new players coming on, getting those combinations working and firing. I'm sure by the end of the tournament they will be slick as you like. Don't forget as well to keep up to date with all the fixtures and results on the official tournament app. So you can find that by searching WSG Netball in your app store. And of course the hashtag that you need for this event, WSG Netball as well, across Facebook, Twitter and Instagram.
Oh.
Lovely move on the goal line. Just a bit of a tangle of legs. There's a lot of legs going on in that circle, isn't there, Luz?
Legs 11, legs for days.
Here they come, Tonyrefail Community School looking for their fifth goal of the game. The score now 31-4 in favour of Dubai English Speaking College. And that is the final whistle. So it is a first win in the first game for Dubai English Speaking College. What do you make of that, Luz?
I mean, that was a blistering start from them. I don't think they could have had a more positive start if they tried. Some really exceptional attacking play, but equally their defensive prowess was extraordinary, turning over so much ball, but then crucially rewarded at the post.
Yeah, absolutely. I think if we had to give a World School Games media player of the match, it would be Danae Hendricks in the goal attack position for Dubai English Speaking College. She was sensational, wasn't she?
Yeah, I mean, the amount of goals that she put in that first half alone really set them up well to be able to try some new things in the second half. So congratulations, Danae, you've absolutely smashed it.
Well, we have our second game of the day, which is Dubai College versus the Grammar School at Leeds, coming up very shortly, and we'll be right back with you in just a few minutes.
Welcome back, everybody, to game two of the World Schools Netball Cup 2023. Now, coming up next, we have the under-15s, Dubai College versus Grammar School at Leeds. Now, I'm really expecting this to be a hotly contested match. Dubai College, very, very strong last year. What do you reckon, Luce?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a good one. I remember the Grammar School at Leeds from last year as well. They did fantastically well in the competition, and I'm very excited to see what both teams can put out today.
Absolutely. So we're going to run you through the starting lineups for each team. So for Dubai College, who are in the white and red, in goal shooter, we've got Ashley Slow. In goal attack, Imani Hussein. In wing attack, we've got Issy Scar. In centre, we've got Ali Ruiz. In wing defence, Sophie Woolley. In goal defence, Olivia Ashcroft. And in goalkeeper, we've got Millie Canavan.
And for the Grammar School at Leeds, who are in the blue and purple today, in goal shooter, Sophie Wilson. Goal attack, Amy Fisher. Wing attack, Eleanor Hassan. In centre, it's Georgie Gold. In wing defence, Sophia Astley. In goal defence, it's Amy Smith. And in goalkeeper, Ellis Baxter.
Now we are one game down of four this evening, four curtain raiser matches to get us underway before a big 2 days of back-to-back netball action. And the first game that we had, it was a relatively big scoreline, wasn't it? At least 31-4, I think, from memory.
Yeah, absolutely. The Dubai English-speaking college were fantastic in that game. They really came out strong and firing. I think they're going to be looking to be in a serious position at the business end of the competition.
Yeah, I completely agree. And teams in their huddles are now making their way onto court in their positions. Grammar School at Leeds in the blue and purple are going to get us underway with the first centre pass of game two. Oh, they're just teasing us, keeping us waiting on the edge of our seat. And here we go. Great availability on the first phase of the centre pass from Leeds, off on 1 foot from Georgie Gould. Look at that, a shooting opportunity within seconds, collecting her own rebound, Sophie Wilson. Wowzer.
Yeah, that was a really strong start from the Grammar School at Leeds. Just good to get that first goal underway and just get that confidence up. And an early turnover as well, by the looks of it.
Yeah, speaking of confidence, Leeds are certainly playing with it early, but a pickup for Dubai College, thanks to the work of Olivia Ashcroft.
Sporting some very glamorous purple braids as well. Are they purple or blue, do you think, Liz?
Oh, good question. I actually think they're blue, but I tell you what, the braid work on the display in this building is
it's extremely stylish.
Outrageous.
And there's Ashley Slow with the first one on the board for Dubai College. I remember her from last year. She's an absolute demon on the baseline.
Dubai College under all sorts of pressure. Obstruction has been called though. They need some forward options. Look at that tracking from Georgie Gould in centre.
Oh, I think that one could have gone either way there.
Who'd be an umpire, eh? Good patience being shown. Someone needs to come available.
Was unlucky there. Ellis Baxter with the hand in, but she gets called for contact.
Oh, and another hand in, this time from Amy Smith. But it is a penalty shot. She collects her own rebound. And Ashley Show gets goal number two on the board for Dubai College and their centre pass.
If there's any shooters listening, always follow your shot. The cardinal rule that coaches always nag you about, isn't it, Luce?
And it's the one thing I don't do as a shooter.
Beautiful drive there. And nice confident swing. There she is again. Ah, but just rushed that a little bit.
Yeah, a bit of an air ball there from Ashley Slow.
Needed to take her time a little bit more on that shot.
And the deflection from Amy Smith. I'm loving this defensive pressure from Leeds. Now, Ellis Baxter out the circle. What can Dubai do if this is a two-on-one? Weren't able to get it directly into goal. Fantastic defensive work. They've come up with the turnover. Oh, and a footwork call on throw-in. That is so unlucky.
That is really unlucky when they've worked so hard to get the ball back.
Yeah, these umpires are hot on the footwork call. We had a few in the first game as well.
Good switching there from the grammar school at Leeds, but just that penalty again. I have to say, Amy Smith is all over it early doors.
Yeah, I'm really liking her energy. Just needs to watch the distance and sometimes just going in that 3 feet.
Yeah, the captain, Ali Ruiz, was all over that one.
Oh, unlucky, Georgie Gord really fought hard for that one. Struggling to find anything in the central channel at the moment. Having to go quite wide, it's through the hands. And a turnover to Leeds again.
They've actually had a lot of opportunities. I think, you know, this early score 3-1, it doesn't totally reflect how much ball Leeds are winning in that defensive end.
No, I would agree. And a very low scoring game already, and another turnover as we speak, right on cue. I'd like to see Ali Ruiz. There we go. She's gone down court a bit now. Just clear out some space. Not
able.
You can
see the coach, Lucia, getting very animated on the sideline. A former England player herself, of course. She's played with the likes of Fiona Murta, Maggie Birkinshaw, some of those real household names in the England setup.
I mean, imagine your first day at school, after school netball club, being coached by an ex-England. Unbelievable.
Incredible.
Lovely shot from Imani Hussein. And that is goal number 4 for Dubai College. Oh, the timing on that second phase. Look at her go. Imani Hussein, beautiful work.
That was absolutely fantastic there, and it all started with the speed of Izzy Scar to get free on that centre pass. She's a little pocket rocket, I have to say.
And down the other end, an equally stunning ball into Sophie Wilson, who nets it away. Just 3 goals in it at the moment.
You feel like both of these teams have sort of settled a bit more now. I think, you know, the first half of the quarter, maybe a little few nerves out there, and I really feel like they're starting to find their flow, particularly on that centre pass. But oh, that was just unlucky there.
Yeah, I mean, we're still getting a few turnovers. That was great work from Hussein to pick that one up for Dubai College. There she is again. Lovely little baseline drive from Ashley Slow. There we go. Ashley Slow.
Did you mean to rhyme?
I actually did not, but I'm embracing it.
You are a poet and you did not realise. The grammar school at Leeds then underway. Oh, just a bit of hesitation. And there it is again. You feel like it's just that pressure, isn't it, from Dubai College?
Yeah, it really is a pressurised situation. Speaking of pressure, here goes Sophie Wilson for the shot. It's a flat one, but it's a good one.
Yeah, and she did well to follow that as well, because it looked like it might be short, but she puts it away. Really dynamic play there from Dubai College. Yeah. Really impressed by their athleticism. Don't forget, there's an under 15 age group, Luce.
Honestly, absolutely unreal, the level of talent at such a young age. Umpire being very clear about where she wants that ball set. Slightly overcooked it.
They did well to hold on to that, Dubai College.
Nice little partnership. Oh, between Imani Hussein and Ashley Slow, just struggling to get that one away, but she gets there in the end.
As long as you get your own rebound, it's fine.
Oh, the inside line from Olivia Ashcroft on that centre pass, and in the blink of an eye, it's already in the Dubai College shooting circle.
Yeah, we've seen that a couple of times today, haven't we? Just that centre giving the ball just when the player isn't quite free of their defender, they haven't made that second move, and the ball just being passed not just enough in front so that cheeky defender can get a little hand in there.
Cheeky defenders, honestly.
They are. Defenders are the cheekiest ones.
Cheekiest of cheeky. Especially that wing defence.
And they always think they're hard done by as well.
To be, I would actually side with them on this one. Nice mid-range shot from Slow. Looking really comfortable now. I'm loving that partnership with Hussein as well in goal attack. And Leeds. Nice use in the central channel. Good front hold from Sophie Wilson. Oh, unlucky not to be able to keep her own rebound just through the hands. That was great speed of footwork from Millie Canavan for Dubai. There's another missed shot from Wilson. Possibly a little bit nervous.
Coaches yelling steady at Dubai College. There was a sense that they might just get a little bit carried away, but they hold on to it. Oh, I thought she had that.
Oh, and it's an attacking contact. Our first one of the day, I think. Oh, but it looks like Amy Smith has taken a bit of a knock to the face. But she's all good. She's good. She's a tough cookie. We're on our way.
There's Smith on the ball again. I've been impressed with her early doors. She's very tenacious as a defender. It's exactly what you want. Arms and legs flying everywhere, just really trying to disrupt that play. And I do think that the Dubai College shooters haven't had it all their own way early doors.
No, not at all. Unlucky there for Amy Fisher. Can't be long left of the quarter now. She's right in amongst it on the defensive pressure. Just 2 minutes to go. Of course, we are doing 12-minute halves for the duration of this tournament.
Yeah, that was a fantastic rebound effort there from Ellis Baxter.
Don't forget, if you are watching, let us know where in the world you're watching from, who you're cheering for. You can get in touch via the hashtag on social media, WSG Netball, or you can get in touch with us directly at Quartertime Pod, QTR Time Pod. We'd love to hear from you. Oh, that defensive pressure from Olivia Ashcroft causing them to do lots of balks on the shot. That was really exemplary work.
Yeah, I have to say as well, I'm loving the partnership between Ashcroft and Canavan. They're switching really well, communicating nicely as well. You can see that Canavan as well, and there's another turnover there for her side. It's so important, that voice you bring as a goalkeeper, isn't it?
Yeah, 100%, and it was the sharp reflexes of Ashcroft that came up with that turnover. Lightning quick. Just getting stuck on the same side of the court, just need to open it up. Oh, and another attacking contact. Oh, I think Hussein's very hard done by there. Looks rather innocuous to me.
From our armchair umpiring position. Oh! Oh, I think Ellis Baxter can't believe it. She thought that was hers all day long.
She's going to have to be quick, though. There's only 6 seconds on the clock. They need to get it in. Oh, I spoke too soon. And there we go, 9-3 in the first half. What do you make of that, Luce?
Well, I think it's really closely contested. I think, unfortunately, it's just been a little bit the shooting percentage for the grammar school at Leeds that's meant they've had some opportunities, but they haven't quite been able to capitalise because they are winning that ball in the defensive end. But Dubai College, very strong, as we've come to expect from them, particularly from the competition last year. Very well-drilled, very slick, very athletic. I'm looking forward to the second half.
Yep, as am I. So don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes for the second half. Welcome back to the second half of game two, day one of World Schools Netball Cup 2023. We have Dubai College in the red and white versus Grammar School at Leeds in the purple and blue for anyone just tuning in. It's an absolute cracker of a game. Dubai College are up by 6-9-3 currently. I think the standout attribute from this game so far has got to be the defensive pressure from both teams, isn't it, Luce?
Oh, absolutely incredible. I think, you know, the first game was all about the attack, and this next game has been about the defence. Again there, Amy Smith with another one.
Dubai taking their time in attack, not giving that first, second ball. Lovely ball over into Ashley Slow.
Yes, and beautifully picked up there from Smith. And now they just need to settle and hold on to it. Don't rush it too much.
Yeah, I mean, they've really made their way into the goal third with some pace there.
It's about that control, isn't it? That, whoa, the harnessing of the power and the speed, and just making sure it's always controlled, always landing your footwork correctly and passing off nicely to your teammates as well.
Okay, Grammar School at Leeds with the centre pass. 1-2-3 into goal. It's going to be a mid-range shot. Oh, but it's a good one.
What a start to the second half from the Grammar School at Leeds. Score now just 9-5. They are definitely still in this game.
Yeah, probably not happy with the score from the first half. I don't think it reflected just how good they are as a team. So they've really come out firing in the second half.
Ooh, the core strength there from Imani Hussein. She's been doing her planks in the gym, hasn't she?
I could only dream of that kind of core strength. Oof. Absolute bullet pass into the circle, but not able to reward it. Dubai College just need to look a little bit down court, bit of tunnel vision there. Timing slightly out. And Leeds get the turnover.
Yeah, that was well chased from Baxter. She knew to leave it as well, just protecting that space. There she is again, another option. Really helping her team.
Oh, much better depth and clearance from Leeds. Just the placement slightly off there. Oh, but Dubai College just looking mighty unsettled in this second half.
Yeah.
A real contrast from the first half.
The coach is very animated on the sideline, but they're well done to pick up that loose ball. Oh!
Oh, you could see where she's going
in
for.
From nowhere. Oh, and there she is again. I've been so impressed by Baxter in this game.
Yeah, but I think as well she's being complimented beautifully by Amy Smith. She's doing so much work out in front to that, sort of not leaving it all to the last line of defence as goalkeeper.
And that's it, isn't it? It's a netball. It's about every person doing their job. Seven on attack, seven on defence, Luce, as you said. Just really slowing that ball down and letting your goalkeeper come out for the glory.
Yeah, I mean, they're glory hunters, aren't they? Everyone says it's the goal shooters, but I disagree. But no, I mean, it's the ultimate team sport in that sense, isn't it? That's why I love it so much. And speaking of teamwork, here come Dubai College.
Oh, there she is again!
Absolutely unreal. Really putting her name up for player of the match, isn't she?
Oh, without a doubt.
And a turnover for Dubai College. Looking for options.
Oh, what a steal! There is nothing more satisfying than tipping the ball and your teammates right there to back you up.
Now a couple of changes for Dubai College. It looks like Imani Hussein's gone to the bench.
Yeah, she was holding her ankle a little bit. She has got some strapping on the other knee. And it looks like she is getting a bit of attention from the team doctor at the moment.
Yeah, the ice has come out. Bit of massaging.
Yeah, that's not what you want in the first game. Hopefully just a stinger.
Really great hustle from Dubai defence in that circle. There is not an inch of room, but that's not a problem for Sophie Wilson.
Yeah, that was a great settler there. And really, look at the scoreline, 10-6 now.
Yeah, I mean, they've halved that deficit. So that is really fantastic from Leeds Grammar School.
Sometimes, though, it is more difficult to be in the lead. Remember, we saw in the Netball Super League final just a couple of weeks ago, London Pulse and Loughborough Lightning. Of course, Loughborough Lightning victorious. They were down at half-time, and they came back in the second half. We could be seeing a repeat of that today, Luce.
We absolutely could. And no doubt some of these guys will be in the Super League in years to come. Ah, oh, straight into the hands of Ellis. Back to then, but it's all topsy-turvy. It's a pick-up now for Dubai College. Top of the circle, straight into Ashley Slow. And the finish as well, that was beautiful.
Yeah, you just felt like that could have been a moment, you know, that could have been 9-10, back within one, and I think that Dubai College may have just saved themselves with that passage of play.
Yeah, well, we've got about 6 minutes left on the clock, so still plenty of time for Grammar School at Leeds to bring it back. But not like that. A little bit overcooked there. Oh, but Georgie Gould. And a little bit of a brain fade. Just need to take that breath when you get a turnover.
Yeah, there's a little bit of ping pong happening at the moment. But Grammar School at Leeds lining up for another one.
Yeah, Amy Fisher didn't want to go from long range, understandably.
Especially not over the arms of these Dubai College defenders. They are rangy.
Oh, try as she might, Sophia Astley just couldn't keep that in for Grammar School at Leeds. And in the blink of an eye, Dubai have streams down court. Oh, there we go again.
Oh, the rejection.
Ellis Baxter, honestly, I cannot say enough good things about this kid.
She has been a brick wall so far in this game.
That is some intense pressure over the shot.
Yeah, they deserve that one. Ooh, two goals in at least. It's getting juicy.
This is getting juicy. And just almost 5 minutes left in this game. Big swing to open up the circle, but shooters just stuck behind their defender at the moment. There we go, patiently worked and netted by Ashley Slow.
Yeah, Slow's been good in this second half. She had a couple of misses early doors in the first half, but she's really settled on that shot. Mid-ranger here, whoa!
That was absolutely sensational from Sophie Wilson. That was not easy. Oh, and here we go, turnover time again. They can bring this back within one. But Dubai College say no.
I think that's gonna be a theme of the weekend, please.
Oh, would you look at that? The deception from Slow, right under the post. That gives them that three goal buffer back.
Really nice quick ball in there. I just love it when teams mix up the feed, you know, and sometimes they're giving it really quickly on that first phase, on that first ball, first, second ball. And then other times really patiently working it around, letting the shooters get comfortable and in a nice good position. It's really hard as a defender to anticipate if you're shooting, if your attacking players, sorry, are always mixing it up.
Oh, and Amy Smith again with another turnover, but threw that one away. Yeah, and Dubai have come up with it.
It's that thing again, Luce, isn't it, of being so vulnerable when you've just got that turnover. Just need someone to hold onto the ball, wait a second, let your players catch up with you, and then bring the ball through there. Otherwise, you do risk losing it. And Dubai College have been so good today.
I have to say, though, props to the attacking work of Ashley Slow. She's really using her whole bag of tricks in terms of her change of direction, her rolls. But not to be outdone, Sophie Wilson down the other end of the court for Grammar School at Leeds.
So less than 2 minutes left now and two goals in it. You going to call it, Luce?
Oh, I think Dubai College are just going to hold on to it. Because when things like that happen... Oh no, they've still got possession. Obstruction for wing defence for Dubai. Lovely front hold by Sophie Wilson under all sorts of pressure. She's going to go for it.
Oh,
it's a good one. Here we go, one goal game and 1 minute left on the clock, and it's their centre pass. This will be the turnaround of the day. The crowd really getting into it. You can hear the other teams from Dubai College trying to cheer them on.
This is when you want your players to just demand the ball. You want them to say, yes, give it to me, I'm going to do it.
And Sophie Wilson is the one to do it. 30 seconds left. They are now 14 apiece. We need the defensive pressure of Grammar School at Leeds Live. They got the turnover.
Oh my goodness me, it was a breaking call.
Oh, we're taking it back. They're going to have to be quick.
Oh.
And Dubai College are here to ruin the day. Are they going to get a goal or is it going to be a draw? Amy Smith. Oh my goodness. What a finish to game two. It is 14 apiece. Our first draw of the competition.
Wow.
Already.
Oh my goodness, that was such an exciting finish to that game. And a really, I think, a well-deserved result. You know, although Dubai College were leading the whole way, but it really felt like the Grammar School at Leeds just kept going on at them, and they really persisted. And they deserved that draw today.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Grammar School at Leeds just came out firing in that second half. And, you know, even if you are ahead, you can't rest on your laurels. You still have to keep attacking the game. And that'll be a really tough lesson learned for Dubai College. But an absolutely outstanding match. And I think for player of the match, who are we going to give it to, Luce?
Well, I don't think you can look past Ellis Baxter, the goalkeeper for the Grammar School at Leeds. I mean, she was fantastic today. She was all over everything. She kept providing her team with multiple turnovers throughout the game. Really consistent as well in the first half and in the second half. And I think she was crucial for me for the Grammar School at Leeds getting that draw today.
I agree with you wholeheartedly. Well, don't go anywhere, folks, because coming up next, we're going to have under-17s Hillcrest International School versus Balerno High School. We'll be back in a couple of minutes.
Ala. In centre, Imani Najerdi Waruhu. In wing defence, Favor Tara Jahumju. In goal defence, Vijun Jessica Elaine. And in goalkeeper, Kim Yemwo Samara Jakepamai.
And for Balerno High School, who are from Scotland, in goal shooter, we've got Ava Sweeney. In goal attack, we've got Katie Hunter. Wing attack is Ella Buchan. Centre is Elliot McCulloch. Wing defence is Rebecca Montgomery. Goal defence is Ella Flockhart. And goalkeeper is Grace Lloyd.
So this third game of the day will be getting underway very shortly. Don't forget as well to get in touch with us using the hashtag WSG Netball on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram. You can also tweet us as well. We are Lucy P and Lucy G from Quarter Time Podcast. We are at Quarter Time Pod. So umpires getting ready here for this third game of the day. Remember, we have a really big packed weekend of netball coming up your way. And the best way to follow along with all the scores, all the fixtures and all the updates that you need to know is to get the World School Games Netball app. You can find that by searching WSG on your app store. Teams getting ready now to get into position. We are running ever so slightly behind this evening. Just so much excitement at the opening ceremony, Luce, wasn't there?
Absolutely. We had the lights go in, we had Atlas the Eagle making an appearance.
Love
showing off his dance moves, putting you to shame with his dance moves, Luce.
Yeah, no, 100%. And Hillcrest International School with the first centre pass here. They are going to the right of your screen in the blue, white and green. Here we are, already immediate defensive pressure there from Balerno High School.
On a very quick shot at goal, but just a little bit overcooked, but mopped up nicely by Katie Hunter.
Really quick goal there in the first 10 seconds of the game. Balerno High School have come to play today for sure. And two quick goals on the board there for the girls from Scotland. And an almost identical tip there on the centre pass, but unfortunately it will be a turnover. Hillcrest with possession. Oh, just telegraphed that one, unfortunately.
Yeah, McCulloch is in amongst it early. That's the third turnover that she's been involved with already, just a minute into the game.
Lovely rebound there. And a beautiful ball over the top. Impressed by the work there from the goal defence for Hillcrest, but she just couldn't stop herself going offside there.
Yeah, I've been excited to see what Hillcrest can do. They are our only team from Kenya in the competition. Absolutely wonderful to have them here for the World Schools Netball Cup.
Don't forget as well, this is the under-17s competition. We have had the under-13s and under-15s playing already this evening, and the under-19s game will follow this one in about 25 minutes or so.
Very unusual shooting action from Ava Sweeney. It's almost like she becomes a little bit unbalanced as she releases the ball.
We do see a lot of shooting actions in netball. Everyone's got quite a unique style, haven't they? You think about Lenise Potgieter compared to a Nat Metcalf, compared to a Kara Konen, compared to a Steph Wood, you know. I think it's about finding that comfortable rhythm.
Yeah, it's about what works for you, but a few misses early on for Balerno High School.
Mm. And now an opportunity for Hillcrest International School. Haven't spent a lot of time in their attacking third so far in this game. Just credit to that defensive pressure from Balerno. That's lovely play and a really excellent finish there from Balerno. Score 5-0 in these opening few minutes. Oh, just a little rush there on that last feed. It was the right idea, but the shooter didn't get the memo.
Yeah, lost in the mail.
But there they are, straight away back on the defence. And sometimes getting a little penalty like that can be a bit of an advantage to your team because it allows the defence to set up and come up with ball like that.
Yeah, Hillcrest just needed to take their time a little bit over that transverse line into their goal third. They're just sort of rushing it a little bit, which is causing the turnover. But Balerno screaming down court. They found Ava Sweeney, who nets it.
Hillcrest being very patient here, working it around. Well kept in as well by the goal attack. Oh, miscommunication there, unfortunately. Little bit of confusion here. It is a sideline.
Umpire being very, very clear about where she wants that ball taken.
Oh, they read that one beautifully, the Balerno defenders.
Yeah, Hillcrest a little bit guilty of standing, waiting for the ball to come to them rather than driving onto it. And a nice shot from Katie Hunter.
And another beautiful passage of play there. Sweeney making no mistake under the post.
Yeah, I feel like she's really settled into the game now.
Heavy fall there for the centre from Hillcrest. Hope Imani is doing okay. Just want to see a forward option coming forward. Just those pesky defenders with their hands in there, spoiling the party for Hillcrest.
Yeah, Grace Lloyd's got some serious reach on her. Just struggling to get around those long arms.
Fantastic experience for these youngsters, you know, under 17s, many of them will be thinking about going off to university in the next few years. This kind of experience and preparation in netball will set them up so well. I always think if you can join a netball club, you got ready-made friends, you've got your fun, you've got your fitness. What's more to like?
Yeah, you kind of set then, aren't you? Oh, it's a strong effort from Faber to try and keep it in, but just not able to maintain possession.
And an opportunity here for Hillcrest. Oh, just getting a little bit stuck there. The goal defence, Jessica Elaine giving instructions for her team to move there.
It's all just become a little bit unsettled now from both teams, I think. Just need to take a bit of a breath. Go back to basics.
Yeah, footwork on the throw in there. And a nice high ball over. Hunter with the finish.
Yeah, that was a definite break in there for Balerno High School. Right, an opportunity now for Hillcrest. Lovely forward option from Meave. Just no one to pass off to.
Oh, a bit of a scramble there in the midcourt. I think it's very important for young players to get to know the umpiring side of things, because then you can take penalties quickly, you know what's happening, you can get yourself, you know, up and away and set up, not worrying about where things are clarifying, and also reading the umpire's hand signals so you know exactly what the penalty is and whether you're out of play or whether you can stay in play. It's a really valuable skill to learn.
Yeah, absolutely. Would encourage any youngster wanting to get a better understanding of the game to do an officiating course wherever you are in the world.
Really nice there from Hillcrest. Oh, just slightly overcooked on that one, and it's going to be a Balerno High School throw-in.
Yeah, I think Mohammed was expecting the obstruction call.
Yeah, unfortunately, you cannot wait for the umpire's whistle. And especially not when Balerno High School are playing at such speed as they are today. Really nice and confident play and attack from them. Just a little bit too much pepper on that pass. Too many Weetabix this morning, perhaps. And Balerno have the ball again in their possession. Ah, but another turnover.
Yeah, just needed a stronger take on that ball. And it finds its way into Meave. She's going to go for it. It's a little bit short and picked up by Grace Lloyd.
Looks like a substitution happening here. The wing attack, Emanuela for Hillcrest, heading to the bench. I'm sure the other girls will be glad of a little rest.
I know I would be, that's for sure.
Especially just playing two halves of 12 minutes. It is fast and furious. Got to take your rest when you can.
Just a minute and a half to go then in this first half. Fantastic speed through court and great placement on the feed.
That was lovely there from Balerno. Just timing really well on those drives, all down one side of the court. Good vision there from Hunter.
One, two, three to go. Can't really ask for much more than that.
So 14 goals to nil at the moment. We are 1 minute left in this first half. Can Hillcrest get their first goal of the game? Ah, denied. Yeah. Lovely tip there from Flockhart.
Yeah, it was a great defensive setup really from the whole unit for Balerno.
Ah, I think it might be an attacking contact. Umpire's pointing this way. Samara was in good front position there, the goalkeeper for Hillcrest International School.
Yeah, I'd like to see Hillcrest just utilise a different choice of pass. We're having a lot of chest passes and possibly should be overhead or shoulder passes just to get away from the arms of their opposition. But an interesting first half. It is 14 to nil.
Yeah, 14 to nil at half time then. We're going to take a short break, but don't go anywhere. A big second half coming right up. Okay, folks, here we are back then for the second half of this game between Hillcrest International School and Balerno High School. This is, of course, the under-17s competition. We have one more game for you this evening. The under-19s will be playing, and then two absolutely packed days of action. To be honest, if you've got anything booked over the next two days, clear schedule, clear diary. There's non-stop netball happening. It's going to be absolutely incredible. We love seeing these young players get their opportunity to shine.
Yeah, just cancel all your plans. Come spend the day with us. We'll keep you company on commentary throughout the entire of the tournament.
If you would like a shout out as well, let us know. Use the hashtag WSGNetball. We love to hear from you, hear where you're watching from in the world. You can also tweet us at QuarterTimePod. That's QTR Time Pod.
And one shout out already for Heather Doherty. She's here supporting her daughter in under 17. She's a goal shooter, Olivia Doherty, and the whole Strathallan team. Big shout out to you. Everyone just grabbing those extra few seconds of rest while we can. It was quite a frantic first half, wasn't it, Luce?
It was, and sometimes it just takes, you know, you just need teams to settle, you know, really ease their way into the competition, start to find those connections as well. A lot of anticipation being built here. Here we go. So, second half of this game underway. And Hillcrest, really nice moves there. It looks like Vijun Jessica Elaine, who was playing goal defence in the first half, has moved into the centre position. Interesting move. Goal defence and centre, you don't often see that.
I mean, that is some versatility right there. Absolutely love to see it.
First goal of the second half then for Balerno High School. Beautiful feed there. Lovely confidence as well. And well held, looking for their first goal of the game. Bend and believe. That's what I always say to my shooters.
Bend and believe. There
we go. And there we have it. First goal of the game for Hillcrest International School. That'll be a good settler for them and a confidence builder going into the rest of the competition. And a breaking call. So here they have the opportunity to double up. Just want to see a few more definite drives towards the ball.
Yeah, and also just a little tweak to the placement as well. Don't want to make it too difficult for your teammates to be able to collect the ball.
That was good defensive work there from the goalkeeper for Hillcrest. But no problem at all for Balerno High School. Racking up number 16 then of this game.
I think Ava Sweeney and Katie Hunter might have swapped positions in that shooting circle as well.
Remember that in this competition we have teams from England, Scotland, Wales, UAE, Kenya and Jersey. So a lot of nations represented. And that's a second goal on the board for Hillcrest as well.
Yeah, fabulous start to the second half of the game. They'll be absolutely wrapped with this. Oh, now there's some sportsmanship if ever I saw it. Giving the goalkeeper a nice friendly hand up and then putting the goal away.
I think that was a footwork in the centre circle there. But it's almost a case of you've got to learn. Everyone learns by making those mistakes, don't they? You know, that's how that anyone will improve and increase their skill level, is by doing something, then maybe it doesn't quite go your way and you know for next time.
Yeah, well, what's that age-old saying? There's no such thing as failing. It's a first attempt in learning.
First attempt in learning. I love that.
Write that one down, folks.
So sideline here for Hillcrest. They certainly have started the second half much more brightly. Oh dear, commentator's curse, I think that was there.
First run of the tournament.
Coming up next for you as well, we have the Judd School versus Gordon School in the under 19 competition. That's going to be starting just after 7:15. Balerno centre pass. 18-2, they lead now. Really nice shooter to shooter interplay there.
Yeah, I'm enjoying the work of Ava Sweeney. She's been pushed out to that goal attack position after starting in goal shooter. Much more settled on her shot now. Doing fantastic work.
We love a versatile player, don't we, Luce?
We love a versatile player.
I think the way that netball is at the moment, you've got to offer more than one position. Only a few spots for specialists in any given team.
Yeah, and actually just for your own development and skill set, I'd really encourage doing versatility within training if you're a club coach or, you know, involved in a club setup at all. Just, you learn something different from playing every position, don't you?
Exactly, and I actually think trying a bit of defending makes you a better attacker because you know what are they going to get a hand to, you know, what are they going to do, and vice versa as well, you know. Being able to understand, okay, this is where they want to receive the ball, so I want to stop that happening, and just really starting to increase those netball smarts.
Yeah, absolutely. Hillcrest with the centre pass then. Oh, lovely ball into the middle of the circle. Oh, but the hold. I think that might have been a held ball, possibly.
Oh, well picked up there. Unfortunately, the goal defence from Hillcrest couldn't hold on to that one.
Oh, I thought she was going to come screaming onto court and get that intercept then.
But they have won the ball back. And just unfortunately they're not seeing the connection between the ball carrier and the receiver before the ball was released. So important, that eye contact, isn't it, Luce?
Yeah, eye contact, verbal communication as well. You could always do a cheeky no look, but you've got to have some way of being able to communicate with your teammates as to what you're thinking.
Lovely triangle set up there. And Balerno notch up number 22 on the board.
I mean, 22 goals in 18 minutes of netball, that's pretty impressive showing.
It's not bad at all, is it? I'm loving the work of Jessica Elaine in the centre position now for Hillcrest. She's really confident in giving that ball. I think that's maybe something that was missing a little bit in the first half, is just that confidence to give ball over the top of the defenders.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough to do, you know, especially the defensive pressure of Balerno.
Hillcrest going back on the centre pass. Lovely punch through the middle there, and good drive. That was a perfect example of a give and go there. The Laura Langman trademark.
Yeah, but I think she just needed to then punch back up towards the ball once her first lead was covered, or for someone else in her team to do a bit of a forward drive.
Yeah, second move. That's what my coach is always shouting at me. Second move, second move. The most surefire way to lose your defender. Keep them guessing. Well kept in there from Hillcrest, but oh, sensational work. McCulloch there. And the finish as well for Balerno. The scoreline has blown out slightly now, 24-3. With the chance to go to 25. Oh, denied. That was a great pickup there from the goal defence.
Yeah, definitely right place, right time. Did well to get two hands to it. Oh, lovely big ball in. Got to rework it, get it closer to post, trying to be cheeky through the legs. Got to keep moving.
This is well gathered. They just need to be patient here. They deserve to get the ball to a shooting opportunity. She's going to go long. But well picked up there and supported by the goal attack. And that's number four.
Yeah, just want to see the goal shooter lift her shooting position a bit so it's not from her chest, it's above her head. That'll really help to evade those pesky defender arms.
McCulloch has been in amongst the action all game, getting another tip there. She's had two different centres on her. Oh, big ball over the top.
Yeah, just struggling for options a little bit.
Oh, snaffled there. Barely even saw where she came from. Just getting a little bit scrappy here. Couple of turnovers consecutively.
Well, there's only about 20 seconds left on the clock now, so they're going to have to be quick to get it in. I clearly can't do maths. We've got a couple of minutes left.
My maths is quite bad.
Hey, this is game three of four, right? Cut me some slack.
Oh, what a finish there, Balerno. Sensational stuff from the Scottish side. Try saying that five times fast.
Sensational stuff.
And another opportunity here. Just a few of those connections haven't quite come off for Hillcrest, but you get the sense that they will grow and learn throughout the competition.
Yeah, I could not agree more. And same for Balerno. I think, you know, they've had a really outstanding game. And the scoreline shows that as well. But I think they're going to get even better as the competition goes
on. That was a ball and a half, wasn't it? Deserved the finish. And they're going to get it back. Oh, no, a little bit of ping pong happening again here. Here we go then, Hillcrest. Nice interplay there between the goal attack and the centre, and she receives the ball again. It will be an attacking contact outside the circle edge. That quick ball again, really impressive. And there's another one, a much, much better second half from Hillcrest. Good defensive effort there from Jessica Elaine. Ooh, no options coming forward there from Balerno, having to recycle. And that is the hooter. The final score then, 26-5 to Balerno High School. Who's your player of the match, Luce?
Oh, for me, I don't think you can look past Ava Sweeney for Balerno High School. A little bit rocky on the shot at times, but really settled into the game and racked up a pretty huge scoreline.
Yeah, can't argue with that at all. I have to give a bit of a shout out as well to Viljoen Jessica Elaine from Hillcrest International School, showing fantastic versatility and really helping her side and being very encouraging and cheering her side on throughout the game. So another fantastic game then for us at game three of the day. Don't forget we have one more game coming up between the Judd School B and Gordon School. That will be starting in just a few minutes.
Welcome back, everybody, to the fourth and final game of day one of World Schools Netball Cup 2023. Now, we're on to the under-19s, aren't we, Luce? We've already had under 13, 15 and 17 today, so this is our first look at the under-19 age groups, and we've got the Judd School B versus Gordon's School. So the Judd School B are the ones in the bibs, and Gordon's School in the forest green. Sort of run us through the starting lineups for Gordon's School then, Luce.
Yeah, so in goal shooter for Gordon's, we've got Ella Price. Goal attack, Sophie Bodell. Wing attack, Jess Wynne Hughes. In centre, it's Amy Millington. In wing defence, Tamara Damani. And goal defence, Libby Lomas. And goalkeeper is Daisy McMahon.
And for the Judd School B, it is their centre pass. In goal shooter, we've got Anna Spivey. In goal attack, Debira Ibironke. In wing attack, Amy Cooper. Centre, Elizabeth Lee. Wing defence, Maddie Walters. Goal defence, Rosie Rawlings. And goalkeeper, Adima Abassi Otu'ai. And it's an early pickup for Gordon's School. Really strong passing through court. Look at the speed that they have just got to goal, but the day has been ruined. Fabulous pickup.
Great hands there from Rosie Rawlings.
Oh, lucky to keep possession there. Oh, spoke too soon. It is a replay ball. Gordon's School absolutely screaming down court.
And a lovely split there from Ella Price in the goal shooter position. It's such an important skill as the shooter to just get yourself that little bit closer to post.
Yeah, you've got to have some seriously strong legs for that. And there's Sophie Bodell for the second goal of the game. Elizabeth Lee then for the Judd School B, straight into the hands of Libby Lomas.
Oh, just overcooked it slightly on that one. And this is going to be an opportunity for the Judd School. Oh, but just a little miscommunication on the placement of that pass.
Yeah, but I think that was testament to the defensive pressure from Gordon School. Every single attacker was riding their player then.
A little cheeky shuffle shot there from Ella Price.
And she gets her first of the game as well. Elizabeth Lee, ball in hand. That pressure on the centre pass is unreal.
Yeah, I thought that Tamara had that there on that first phase. Oh, a screamer from Libby Lomas. Yeah. Put that in your highlights package, eh?
She's in amongst it early, that's for sure. And Ella Price again. Five goals already in the first two and a bit minutes. Wow, what a centre pass to goal. And the spin in the air on the receipt of the ball from Ella Price as well.
It was almost balletic.
Balletic, wasn't
it?
Yeah.
Oh, that defensive pressure again on the centre pass. And there she is. Tamara screaming in there for another one.
Ella Price again. Does not disappoint. And their centre pass as well. Taking the ball nice and wide on the first and second phase. Into a fabulous shooting position for Sophie Bodell. Picked up by Price and finished off. Oh, again, the absolute defensive pressure from Tamara Diamini is wild. There she is, ball in hand. Good option to reset from Gordon School. Ella Price has just caught behind her defender, but not any longer. Little shooter to shooter play. Just can't quite finish that one off. Players taking a breather while they can. Cheeky little 1-2 and into the net.
Oh, she did well to hold on to that, but umpire deemed a replay call. That's very unlucky there. I was just about to say what lovely depth in second phase, but unfortunate there. She couldn't hold on to it.
Yeah, I always want to try and get two hands to ball if you can, but it was a bit of an awkward take. Well, good arms over from Wynn Hughes. Oh, good vision, straight to post.
I think that's what we call a home alone, Luce.
Oh, it's our first Sue Gordian moment.
Macaulay Culkin.
Elizabeth Lee then for the Judd School B. Oh, and again into the hands of Libby Lomas. She must have had, what, three, four pickups already?
Oh, a heavy fall there. In the centre position, Elizabeth Lee is down. She is a little slow to get up. Hope she's okay.
Yeah, I think the Judd School just struggling a little bit with the speed of play from Gordon School. It's so hard when the ball, if you're a defender, the ball's screaming down court towards you. It's so hard.
It's very little you can do. It's very, very difficult. I think Gordon School have come out very strong already in this first half. Halfway through the first quarter, and it's 11-0.
Judd School showing good patience. Just need to look at some of the timing and the strength of the drive.
Oh,
and Lomas
stolen.
Again.
Yeah, she read that one really nicely.
That was a nice little hand in there from 0-2 IE. And a beautiful shot from Bodell. Wow, that was pretty slick. And Bodell can't quite finish it off, but what a rebound from Price. Unlucky not to keep hold of it.
Really quick back in defence though, aren't they, Gordon School?
Absolutely.
Oh,
it was a big...
if it hadn't been for that obstruction, they probably would have got another turnover there. Get the sense there's a couple of tired legs out there. I know it is the first game of the competition for these teams, but it is still also 20-8 on a Friday.
Thursday. Are you tired, Luce?
I'm not sure. I think I got my days confused.
What do you think as well? You know, these are international schools. There's a lot of travel involved for a lot of them. So, yeah, you're probably right. There probably are some tired legs already. A lot of coach sitting, perhaps.
Yeah, too much dancing on the bus, making TikTok videos, probably.
We see Ella Price with another crack at it. Manages to settle that one. And Elizabeth Lee into the centre circle then for the Judd School. Good back up from the goal defence.
And we have got a shout out here from Paul Watley on Twitter, who's got in touch using the hashtag WSGNetball. He says, can we give a shout out to his two granddaughters, Megan and Lottie Watley, who are playing for Clifton College? And that's from Paul and Grace Watley, presumably Granny and Grandpa, sending in their best wishes and watching online. Fantastic to hear from you, Paul. Hope you're enjoying the day so far. We'd love to know where you're watching from as well. Do get in touch. That hashtag is WSGNetball.
Or you can get in touch with us directly if you so wish at Quarter Time Pod. That's QTR Time Pod on Twitter and Instagram.
And while you're at it, make sure you're following WSG events as well. That's going to keep you updated with all the action. There's also some really good interviews and content that's going to be coming out over the next couple of days. So you can really follow along and get invested in what's going on in the competition this weekend.
Yeah, fill your boots with all the netball goodness.
It's
Speaking of netball goodness, Judd School just getting a little bit stuck over the transverse line, but a nice clearing ball into Anna Spivey. Oh, good hustle from Tamara. I have to say there has been some relentless defensive work from Gordon School already. Just 9 minutes into the game.
Yeah, I really like as well, they're very confident to take on the player physically as well. You know, that's such an important skill of the game these days. Netball isn't a, well, it's non-contact fully contested, right? As Jez Thelby puts it.
Absolutely.
But it means you have to be able to withstand that physical pressure and really just put everything out there on the line and not be afraid to come into contact with people and to come up against them within the rules of the game, of course. But, you know, that's how the game is played. If you watch the internationals, if you watch Super League, SSN, ANZ, all of that stuff, it is very physical. These are incredible athletes, you know, that we have in our game. And it's something to be celebrated.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more. And right on cue, a little bit of a tussle for the ball. And it is the Judd School that come up trumps. Just a little bit clustered for the Judd School. That's a good drive. Nice depth into the pocket. Not quite the execution on the feed just yet.
Oh, that was outrageous on the circle edge. Oh, such a pity her teammates couldn't be back up for there. But there she is again.
Yeah,
Tamara,
really
sensational work. That is so difficult to do.
Really strong challenging in the air on circle edge. A couple of deflections, it puts Spivey off her shot, and it is going to be a Gordon School throw-in.
Sometimes that's what it's about, isn't it? You know, it's that intense build-up of pressure, and especially in the wing defence position, you don't always necessarily win the ball for your team, but you are instrumental in, you know, that turnover actually occurring, because it just disrupts the rhythm of the shooters. Shooters want to be nice and cozy, don't they? They want to be feeling the vibes, they want to be going in their flow and in their rhythm, and if you can disrupt that as a defender at whatever stage of the court you're doing that, you're onto a winner.
Yes, as a shooter myself, we do like to be nice and cozy. I think as well,
nobody said princesses, nobody said that. It's the princess blood wasn't brought up.
But there's also the psychological side of it as well, particularly in, you know, the underrated wingding position. You know, if you can put the fear of
wingding,
if you can put the fear of God into your wing attack and stop them from feeding the circle altogether, then, you know, job done.
Yeah, exactly. And it's just about applying that consistent pressure as well. I mean, you think about some of the best wing defences in our game, your Ash Brazzles, Beth Cobdens, they're just consistent throughout the game, putting that pressure on for 60 minutes.
Absolutely. Well, that is the first half done and dusted. It is 17-0 to the Gordon School. Let's see what the Judd School B can come out with in the second half. Coming your way in just a couple of minutes.
blue one.
Welcome back, everybody, to the second half of our final game between the Judd School B and Gordon School. This is an under 19. We've already had the three other age groups this morning, and this is our first look at an under 19 matchup. And what a matchup it has been. It's been a fiery start for Gordon School, picking up where they left off with goal number 18. Oh, a little bit too deep on that second phase. Couldn't quite keep hold of it. We see Elizabeth Lee has moved into that wing attack position for Judd School.
Oh, Libby Lomas again. Just with that tip, she's moved into the wing defence position now. Really love to see that versatility. The wing defence, goal defence side isn't a common one, is it? See a few, Zara Everett springs to mind.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of people who can play it, like Fran Williams.
Used to of course, do a lot of Layla Guskoff, we saw recently in the recent England series.
Fumi Fidoju, of course.
Our favourite. How could we forget? Can't believe we're on game four and we haven't mentioned Fumi Fidoju.
It is a rarity for us, president and CEO of the fan club. Elizabeth Lee then for the Judd School. It's a big swing over the circle. All sorts of pressure over the shot there from Tamara Diamini.
Yeah, she was unlucky to be too close there, but they collect the rebound. This is really nice work from Gordon's. Just need to hold on to it.
Yeah, they just miss Ella Price coming off that hold ever so slightly too early.
But what I liked actually about that, Luce, is she didn't then just wait there. She re-offered and moved again, and I think that's an important skill.
Absolutely. There we go again. Just missed that first second ball, but not a problem. They swing it to the other side of the circle. Working it around. There we go. Right under post. Happy days. So the Judd School B still yet to score in this game. I mean, that's pretty tough going mentally when you're struggling to get on the scoreboard, but showing such resilience to keep attacking this game. Really giving it everything they've got.
And that's what you have to think about. You know, it is a long competition. They've got lots of matches tomorrow, lots of matches on Saturday. And there's going to be those games that you're really targeting. And, you know, that's where you should keep your priority and your focus.
Beautiful movement from Ella Price. Lovely little roll off the body. Gordon School really not missing a beat at all.
Yeah, it's just that passing into space as well, isn't it? Just unlucky there on that last occasion. But through that whole passage of play, just every ball was just put exactly where it needed to go. So their attacking player was on the stretch, and another win back there from them.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing I love more in a game of netball when an attacker gets an intercept. So yeah. It just fills my heart with joy.
Oh, I thought she was going to have that one as well.
Well, it was good placement from Lee. Just contact on the hand from Diamini. It's a big shot. It's a little bit short. I think there might have been a couple of fingertips on it. Oh, try as she might, could not keep that in.
Yeah, it is difficult when it feels like things aren't quite going your way. But just so important to keep your head up, keep staying in the game, and keep looking for those little wins as well.
Oh, I have to say, I love the speed that Gordon School are using to get through court. It's really impressive, but it doesn't feel uncontrolled. It doesn't feel like they're letting momentum sort of get the better of them. And a little change here. Ella Price taking to the bench. Potentially resting some legs,
I have to say.
Absolutely. Wow, so that was pretty impressive combination there in attack. Obstruction called against Gordon School. Lovely ball in from Lee. Oh, just a little bit short, so unlucky. She will get one of them though, keep going. Got to keep putting up those shots.
Beautiful front position. And just very poetic on that finish as well.
Yeah, on the finish, but also on the landing, you know, that split landing. Like we said earlier, absolutely borderline balletic. Looking very, very comfortable now is the goal attack for Gordon School.
Yeah, the goal's coming thick and fast now for Gordon School.
A little bit of confusion as to where the penalty is being taken. It is going to be on court for Judd School, being Tamara from out of nowhere. Looking for options. Oh, it's a big ball in. Probably wasn't the right choice of pass. Maybe needed to work that round the circle a little bit. Bit of conversation happening here. Looks like we're going to have another change. Umpires and coaches having a little bit of a natter on the sideline. Just clarifying when those changes can be made.
Just a reminder then, of course, our first game tomorrow is going to be at 9 a.m. It is the Dubai English Speaking College 2 against Gordon School, and it's under 13s. So that will be coming to you live from the Netball Centre tomorrow morning. And then games all the way until 5 p.m. tomorrow, and the same again on Saturday. And there will be a presentation, of course, for our lovely winners at the end of the competition. Last year it was a Dubai College clean sweep. Can they do it again? I think a few other teams are going to have a bit to say about it.
Absolutely. Even already four games in, we've seen some pretty extraordinary talent. The Judd School B then. Can they get this one to goal and get their first goal of the game? Oh, she's going to get a second crack at it. Go on, we're all willing it. Yes! There we go. Fabulous. Oh, that'll give them a bit of a boost.
Yeah,
no
that's
doubt.
Really good. Very well deserved there. And they might be able to back it up now if they can get this turnover. Great hustle.
I would have thought that'd be a bit of footwork. A bit lucky to get away with that one.
Oh, no. Looks like it is out of court, and it's going to be a Gordon School sideline. So quick off the mark, and just that vision to open up the goal shooter. Wow, she's only just turned up, as in come onto the game.
Yeah, I mean,
and the goal shooter
court.
Just, no worries, easy as you like, just popping them in from anywhere. That's what we love to see, isn't it, Luce?
Absolutely, as a shooter myself. It is a pretty great A little bit of whistle coming the Gordon School way now. Just need to remain disciplined and tidy in your defensive efforts, but they come up with the spoils.
And that was really good work there from Gordon School, just confusing the space for that feeder.
Whoop, a bit too much pepper on that pass from Tamara Diamini. She knew exactly what she'd done then. Hand to the mouth as soon as she threw it. Look at this defensive pressure from Gordon School, and they come up with the intercept straight into their goal shooter, who finishes it off no problem. She really has just rocked up and bossed, didn't she?
Yeah, absolutely. Nice there. Really good availability, good accuracy.
Yeah, and again with the split landing, it's so impressive. Less than 2 minutes to go. Just a couple of words being had. Just some clarification from the umpire, which is really great to see. Gives
yeah,
the girls
exactly.
lots to work
Don't on. Don't forget that, of course, these youngsters are still learning. Oh, wow, great intercept there. But, you know, it's important for the umpires to be clear about what they're expecting from players and just to make sure that, you know, they're doing everything by the book, as it were.
Goal shooter taking a wander out of the circle, finds her shooting partner spectacularly, who finishes it off as well. There is just no stopping Gordon School in this game. A pretty sensational way to open their tournament.
Oh,
look at that outside arm from Tamara.
Ah, oh, but it's been called back. I don't know what that was there, to be honest. Was it footwork?
I'm not 100% sure, but the Judd School are going to go with it regardless. Can they get goal number two? Obstruction called. Oh, so unlucky.
Not long left on the clock now. You can feel the intensity.
Oh, time just ran away with Gordon School then, beaten by the buzzer. And that is a final score of 33-1 to Gordon School. Luce, what did you make of that game? Who's our player of the match?
Well, I thought it was fantastic effort from both sides, particularly Gordon School. They obviously, the scoreline has gone in their favour, but the Judd School, they really persisted. They never gave up throughout the game. However, I'm going to give the player of the match to someone from Gordon School. It is Tamara Diamani. She started the game in wing defence, moved into that goal defence position. She was disrupting. She was relentless. She was absolutely fantastic in my view, and I think she's a well-deserved player of the match.
I could not agree with you more. Read the play beautifully. And there you have it, folks. That is day one done and dusted. 4 games in the bag already. And as Lucy mentioned earlier, we are going to be back tomorrow at 9 a.m. bright and early. We're going to have Dubai English Speaking College 2 versus Gordon's School, and that's going to be an under 13. And if this match is anything to go by, that is going to be an absolute corker. So make sure you tune in. Don't forget, you can keep us posted on the hashtag about where you're going to be watching from. It's hashtag WSG Netball. Follow us at QuarterTimePod and at WSG Events as well.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in to day one of the World Schools Netball Cup 2023. We'll see you in the morning.